Welcome to a lesson on unit vectors. The goals of this video are to determine a unit vector in the same direction as a given vector, and also to determine a vector that intersects the unit circle. A unit vector is a vector with magnitude or length 1. Two very useful unit vectors are the I vector and the J vector. Vector I is the vector 1, 0, meaning it's 1 unit along the positive x-axis. Vector j is a vector 1 unit along the positive y-axis. With vectors I and j, any vector in component form a, b can be expressed in the form of a times vector I plus b times vector j, and this is often referred to as a linear combination of I and j. And we see it again here. Here's an illustration of vector I along the positive x-axis. And here's a graph of vector j, which is 1 unit along the positive y-axis. Now, to determine a unit vector u in the same direction of v, we need to take vector v and divide by the magnitude of vector v, or we could multiply vector v by 1 over the magnitude of v. The result would be the same. And this process of finding the unit vector is often called normalizing vector v. And just to refresh your memory, to find the magnitude of vector v as a position vector or in component form, we need to find the distance from the origin to the terminal point of the vector, which can be found by taking the square root of a squared plus b squared in this form. So let's go ahead and take a look at some examples. Here we want to write the given vector as a linear combination of vector I and vector j, and then we want to normalize the vector, which means we want to find a unit vector in the same direction as this vector. So for part 1, we can rewrite this as a linear combination of vector I and j by just writing 4 times vector I minus 3 times vector j. Now, to normalize it, we first have to find the magnitude of vector v. The magnitude of vector v is going to be the square root of 4 squared plus negative 3 squared. Let's go ahead and simplify this. It's going to be the square root of 16 plus 9, which is a square root of 25, which is equal to 5. So the magnitude of vector v is equal to 5. So now to find the unit vector for vector v, we need to take vector v and divide by the magnitude of vector v, or multiply vector v by 1 over the magnitude. So let's go ahead and do the latter. We're going to take 1/5 and multiply it by vector v, which is the vector 4, negative 3. So the unit vector in the same direction of vector v would be the vector with the x component 4/5 and the y component negative 3/5. So this vector has its initial point at 0, 0, and terminal point at 4/5, negative 3/5. Let's go and take a look at this graphically. In blue, we have the original vector v, which was the vector with the components 4, negative 3. And then in red here, we have the unit vector with components 4/5, negative 3/5. So notice they both have the same direction. It's just that vector u, or the unit vector, has length or magnitude of 1. While we're talking about unit vectors, it's also helpful to refer to the unit circle. The reason this is helpful is if we have a position vector with magnitude 1, the terminal point of the vector would be on the unit circle. And the reason that's important is the x and y coordinates on the unit circle would give us the component form of the vector. So if we call this vector v, we could write vector v with the x component of square root 3 over 2, and the y component would be 1/2. So to summarize this, if u is a unit vector, And theta is the angle from the positive x-axis to the vector u, then the terminal point of the vector will be on the unit circle. So the component form of the vector could be written as cosine theta comma sine theta, or using the unit vectors I and j, cosine theta times I plus sine theta times j. And if v is not a unit vector, as long as you know the magnitude of v, we can also determine the component form of the vector by taking the magnitude of vector v and multiplying it by cosine theta comma sine theta, or as a sum of vectors I and j. Let's go ahead and give this a try. Determine the unit vector that forms a 120 degree angle with the positive x-axis in standard position. Then determine a vector in the same direction with magnitude 3, and then sketch both vectors. Let's get an idea of what's happening here. Here's the coordinate plane. Our vector forms a 120 degree angle with the positive x-axis, so it would look something like this, where this would be 120 degrees. So if we drew a reference triangle, this would be a 60 degree reference triangle in the second quadrant. And since we know this is a unit vector, we could label the hypotenuse 1 unit. The shorter leg would be -1/2, and the longer leg would be √3/2. So remember from the previous screen, our unit vector is going to equal cosine theta, which is 120 degrees, comma sine 120 degrees. Now that we have our reference triangle, our unit vector is going to equal cosine 120 would be -1/2, and sine 120 degrees would be √3/2. So here's our unit vector. Now if we want to find another vector that has the same direction but has a magnitude of 3, let's call it vector v, we can just take our unit vector and multiply by our magnitude of 3. And I copied our notes down here from the previous screen just in case you need to refer to it. So our vector v with magnitude 3 will have the components -3/2 and 3√3/2. So again, just to emphasize, here's our unit vector that satisfies the given conditions, and here's our vector with magnitude 3 in the same direction. Let's go and take a look at this graphically. Here's our unit vector that forms a 120 degree angle with the positive x-axis, and here is the vector v in the same direction with magnitude 3. Okay, that's going to do it for this video. I hope you found these examples helpful. Thank you for watching.